Aqua Dragons.
Aqua Dragons spend a day in zero gravity. An experiment from these amazing students. Oh, and this brave teacher. That's never been done before. Tiny prehistoric creatures launched into zero gravity. Well, not like that, but on a zero-G plane with the help from Space for Teachers. But hold up, why? Stick around to find out. But first, what exactly are Aqua Dragons?
So, have you ever seen any live Aqua Dragons before? Just check these out. Okay, so what are Aqua Dragons? They are these tiny little crustaceans that you can hatch and grow in a tank, and they live in saltwater bodies, so they're already present all over Earth in different seas, oceans, and salt lakes. And they have, I guess it's called diapause, but it's a process that allows them to lay eggs that don't hatch until they've been dried out and then come back into contact with water, and that's how they survive drought periods.
Thanks, Amy. So, as you were saying, these little creatures can survive extreme conditions, like space. That's right, this isn't their first cosmic adventure. Back in 2017, Aqua Dragons went to space's eggs. We sent 2 kilos of Aqua Dragon eggs, that's over 13 million of them, on an unmanned mission past the stratosphere and into near space. These creatures aren't just classroom curiosities, they're space-tested survivors. But this time, we went even further. Real live Aqua Dragons, real zero gravity. Hillsboro Charter Academy, located in Virginia, where this wild idea became a reality with the help of some seriously curious kids. And one seriously brave teacher. Meet Megan Tucker, STEAM specialist, ZeroG explorer, and the kind of teacher who brings science to life.
Hey there, I'm Megan Tucker. I am the STEAM specialist at Hillsboro Charter Academy, as well as the dean of curriculum, the gifted teacher, and a teacher of technology. I have an amazing opportunity this year to work with Space for Teachers, and the experiment I decided to focus on was one with Aqua Dragons. Meet my dragons. I have been training them, catching them, taking care of them, doing everything needed for them to be nice and large and healthy. And in fact, it hasn't been me. It has been my school full of scholars. Every classroom has a tank of dragons, and they are raising them and watching them and seeing how they behave on Earth so we can figure out what happens when we take them into microgravity.
Back at Hillsboro Charter Academy, a team of mini scientists were getting to work. This wasn't just a teacher-led project. This was their experiment. From the very beginning, these students helped design the mission. They prepped tanks, read instructions, and carefully prepared the Aqua Dragons for launch day.
These three ladies, they're in charge of their care. I want to give you the rest of the team real quick, and then we'll get their questions. Leo, if you want to raise your hand a minute. If you're on Leo's team, raise your hand. And you want to tell her what your team is for the experiment?
So our team is the mission catchers. So first, like, space missions and NASA missions all have mission patches.
Hang on. A mission patch, we have some nods, more than one, to Aqua Dragons hidden on our patch, so we're gonna see if you guys can find them. And then our next team, you guys in the front, what is your team?
The Earth Aqua team. And it's where some kids, everybody in the school, they helicopters, and people voted on which ones they thought were the best.
Last team, Camden, what is your team? Your teammate's absent, but your team is?
Different lights and fabrics, see which one would be like dark enough to let the light through, and we could see how they react to the light and darkness.
The students had 2 big science questions they wanted to test in microgravity. How do Aqua Dragons swim in microgravity? Do they react the same
to
light, or does their behavior change?
That's interesting.
To find out, they designed a clever experiment. A clear tank to watch their swimming, and a light and dark test using a blanket and a flashlight. So, what do the students think will happen to Aqua Dragons in microgravity?
It's Genevieve, and I'm in 3rd grade, and I think that the Aqua Dragons that we're raising, I feel like since in microgravity the water makes into little bubbles, I feel like the Aqua Dragons are gonna go into the bubbles.
So you think there's gonna be little bubbles of dragons all over
the water?
That'd be pretty cool to see.
Hang on. How does a zero-G plane work? Well, zero gravity isn't magic, it's science. A special plane flies up, then dives down in a big curve called a parabola. During the dive, everything inside feels weightless, just like astronauts in space. Just 2 days left until we take our Aqua Dragons to zero gravity. Let's get everything packed and ready.
I'm gonna show you the travel
way for your Aqua Dragons. They're about to get on an airplane and they are headed to Kansas, where they'll wait patiently for their ZeroG flight on Wednesday.
Aqua Dragons!
Okay, I'm at the airport, getting ready to check in. Got the dragons in my backpack. They're zipped up and ready to go.
Night before flight day. I'm getting ready. I'm excited. The dragons are ready. Let's check on them. They're over by the window.
Just tucking in the dragons. You guys have a big day tomorrow. All the kids at HCA are counting on you. And all the kids all over the world are watching to see what you're gonna do when you get put into microgravity. Good morning, dragons. This is your day. It's time to fly.
Flight day is finally here. Megan's packed everything. Tanks, cameras, lights, and the Aqua Dragons are ready to fly. Plus, something special. A sealed pack of Aqua Dragon eggs. One day, you might hatch a set that's actually flown in microgravity. Now let's hear what ZeroG thinks about the experiment.
I'm really excited to see what the results of this experiment are and how it goes forward and informs what we do next.
Before the flight takes off and Aqua Dragons make history, we're getting an exclusive behind-the-scenes look at the incredible plane that makes it all possible. Let's take a tour with Megan and Keri Edwards, Vice President of Operations at ZeroG.
Okay, we'll come up here. All this stuff, maintenance just has it up here because they're going to be putting in these foot straps. So these foot straps will be put in the plane. You can see they're kind of like spaced all over.
Yeah.
They're putting in more of them and they'll basically zigzag all through the cabin.
Oh, wow.
You have handholds here, and what'll happen is each person will put a foothold in,
okay?
Megan and the crew need to check in and go through the important pre-flight briefing.
I'm gonna start with a quiz. The quiz today is, who here can tell me how many bathrooms are on G-Force One?
Zero.
Zero. That means go pee, and I'll start one more time. Go pee.
Here we go. On this lovely rainy day, loading up the dragon box. Aqua Dragons will stay with me.
Right, going on the plane. Up the steps, and away we go.
Down through the rails. We're about to get up. Sign is off.
Aqua Dragons in Zero G in.
I just got off of the zero G flight and I took these dragons into microgravity and it was pretty awesome. On the return, now that we're back on Earth, there's no dragons swimming in the middle of my tank. They're all swimming around the edges, which I think is pretty fascinating. The one tank that I could see that I had out, this tank formed a bubble, an air bubble in the middle. So I'm wondering if these guys might've learned a lesson and that's why they're swimming around the outside. It was the most amazing thing ever. Science is very hard to do when gravity goes away. When I was trying to do the light experiment, I ended up literally upside down, trying to shine the light to see what they, how they would react. So it definitely took a lot more energy than I thought to do science on the microgravity plane, but it was a lot of fun and the dragons seemed very happy. They had a great time and hopefully they won't be scared of the middle of the tank after a couple of days, so.
Thank you. I also flew some raw eggs in my bag. That were in microgravity, and we're going to see if those eggs hatch any differently when they're back on Earth.
just because they've had that weightless experience.
Recap time. Aqua Dragons can survive microgravity. They floated vertically, using air bubbles just like the students predicted.
Like spheres of Aqua Dragons.
Okay, so they'll be trapped in little spheres of water?
Megan returns to tell all.
You that these dragons, this is where they flew, in my pocket, and they went to microgravity and they came back and they are so happy. And it is because you guys raised such healthy dragons. So give yourselves a round of applause.
So that's it. Aqua Dragons have made history. From the classroom to zero gravity, they're now officially world record breakers.
Thank you, Aqua Dragons!
Hatch your own Aqua Dragons at home. Start your journey at aquadragons.net. A special thanks to the amazing students of Hillsboro Charter Academy, their inspiring teacher, Mrs. Tucker, Space for Teachers, Laura and Kevin. Want to try your own space science project? Visit spaceforteachers.org. And a special thanks to our partners at Goliath Games. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe, and share it with your space squad.
Aqua Dragons.